A sitemap is a blueprint of your website. It is a structured list of all the pages, posts, and important content on your site, organized in a way that makes it easier for both users and search engines to understand how everything connects on your site. There are two main types of sitemaps, and they serve different purposes. The first is the HTML sitemap. It's usually a regular page on your site that lists all your pages, kind of like a table of contents. Visitors can click through and explore everything you have, especially if your site has lots of sections or hidden pages. It helps with navigation and improves user experience. The next is the XML sitemap. It is a special file written in a language that search engines like Google can read. Instead of focusing on design, it gives bots a clear roadmap of every page on your site, so they can crawl and index your content faster and more accurately. Our focus in this video is to share with you some tools to easily generate an XML sitemap for your website, regardless if you use WordPress, Shopify, or whatever. Let's go! Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress users, and this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, consider subscribing. Anyway, we'll first discuss XML sitemap generators for WordPress, and then we'll move on to generators for other platforms. Well, if you run a WordPress website, an XML sitemap is automatically generated for you. As you can see, I've deactivated all the plugins, so there are no additional functions running in the background. As we add sitemap.xml behind our domain, we will see that WordPress has generated an XML sitemap index automatically. Each of these links is an individual sitemap. As we click on, for example, this, it will list all the indexable URLs. And the page that keeps all the different sitemaps in one place is the sitemap index. So for WordPress users, you are fortunate because it is done for you in the background. But to make it even more awesome, this coming WordPress plugin will automatically submit your sitemap to Google Search Console. If you have installed the free version of RankMath on your WordPress site, you can head over to RankMath SEO and you will see the sitemap settings here. If you don't see this, you can go to its dashboard and make sure that you toggle the sitemap module on. As soon as you have done that, you will see the sitemap settings in the menu. And from here, you will see the link to your sitemap index here. Click on it, and this is how your XML sitemap looks. You can access the sitemap the same way you do on a default WordPress sitemap. Just type sitemap.xml at the back of your domain, and you can access the sitemap. Anyway, for RankMath to automatically submit the XML sitemap to Google, you can visit RankMath's dashboard and click on the setup wizard. Normally, when you first install RankMath, you will be redirected here. As you go through the steps and connect your RankMath account, it will also ask you to connect your Google account that manages the search console of your website. Follow through with it, and in a couple of seconds, your site will be connected to your search console. Now let's go to Google Search Console, and from here, let's click on the sitemaps tab. And you will see that your XML sitemap has been submitted. And in case you are not using WordPress, here's where you add your sitemap URL for submission. So if you use RankMath on your WordPress website, you don't have to lift a finger because most of your SEO work will be done in the background. And the best part, whenever you publish, update, or delete pages, your XML sitemap will automatically be updated and sent to Google Search Console. Now, there are other sitemaps RankMath provides as well, so if you want to learn more about them, you can check out this video right here. The link is in the description. Now, let's venture out to generate sitemaps for websites on other content management platforms. If your website has less than 500 pages, you can use this tool for free. Simply visit this URL and you can add your site's URL here. Following that, click Start. And the tool will start scanning your website for indexable URLs. Once done, you will see how many pages are scanned and added to the XML sitemap. Click on View Sitemap Details. And from here, you can download this file and upload it to your site's domain root folder. If you don't know how to do it, you need to log into your hosting account, and you should be able to access the site's file manager. From here, you can access the public HTML, and you can upload your XML sitemap from here, simple as that. And once your sitemap is on the root folder, you can visit the file and copy the link, and head over to Google Search Console and paste the URL here. Remove the domain and submit it. And there you go. Now, if your site has below 500 pages, this free tool will be great for you. But if your site has more than that, then you may need to upgrade to the Pro account. And it will also automatically update your sitemap as well. Now, Octopus.do is a visual sitemap creator and is especially helpful for web designers to visualize and plan their sitemap if they are doing it from scratch. And it's a freemium too. As you go to the site, you can sign up for a free account to test things out. When you are in the My Projects page, you can click on this button to crawl or import your existing sitemap. We will use the crawler option, and then you would add your site's URL here. Then choose whether you want to crawl only your pages or together with the meta tags. For example, follow, no follow, index, no index, etc. And then if you have a directory where you don't want the tool to crawl, for example, every URL with this prefix or keyword, you can add them here and click crawl. In a couple of seconds or minutes, depending on how big your site is, it will provide you with a visual sitemap. And this is how our sitemap looks visually. If you want to export this into an XML sitemap file, you can click on Share and select Export. From here, you can export your sitemap to other formats, but for these, you will need the pro version. But what we need is the sitemap.xml file option. Otherwise, you can directly upload the file to WordPress or Figma as well. But let's click on this. Add your domain URL, click Generate, and this sitemap.xml file will be downloaded to your computer. From here, you will need to upload this file to your site's root folder, as I've shown you earlier. So Octopus.do is a cool sitemap generator, but the next tool is one that most seasoned SEOs know. So Screaming Frog is unlike other tools because it is not web-based. It is a program that you have to install on your computer. You want to visit screamingfrog.co.uk and click on the SEO Spider 2. Following that, click on Download. You can select the download file according to your operating system. And once you have downloaded and installed the program, you will see this interface. For the tool to start crawling your site, you want to add your site's URL here and hit Start. Depending on how big your site is, it might take a while for the tool to crawl. And once it is at 100%, you can click on Sitemaps and select XML Sitemap. From here, you'll be able to configure your sitemap. Do you want to include your no-index pages, canonicalized pages, or others in the sitemap? Generally, as best SEO practice, you wouldn't want to add them to the sitemap, so you can leave these empty. And you only want HTML pages with the 200 OK response to be added. 300 plus response codes are mainly for redirected pages, and 400 plus pages are mainly for non-existence or forbidden pages. So generally, we wouldn't want them in the sitemap. Following that, you can choose to include the last modified date of the pages in the sitemap, but this is completely optional. If you use RankMath, our XML sitemap will only include the last modified date as well as the number of images on each page. So this is an attribute that you may consider adding. If you want to include it, you can check this box and select either Use Server Response, meaning the date of modification that your server knows. This follows the time and date you have edited the page on your site, or you can select a custom date, but normally you will select this. And then the priority is another optional attribute, and its purpose is to provide a hint to search engines of the importance of a URL relative to other URLs on your site. So if a URL has a 0.5 priority, it gives a hint to the search engine that the URL is not as important as the one with the 1 priority. But in this day and age, search engines are able to tell which pages are more important without you adding the priority. So it is totally fine not to include it in your XML sitemap. Then the change frequency is optional as well. These options only provide hints to search engines, but search engines will crawl URLs as frequently as it determines algorithmically. The images are optional as well, and if your site is multilingual, you can check this. And finally, click on Export to generate the XML sitemap. Select a location to save your sitemap, and once saved, you can upload it to your site's root folder. So these are the best sitemap generators for your website, regardless if you use WordPress or not. And if you know any others, feel free to let us know in the comments down below. And if this video helped, do help us out by smashing that thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. And if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.